Metrocele is a condition we pelvic physiotherapists cannot treat. However, when treating patients with anorectal complaints, it's very important to know when we can consider an Entrocele, and that's the topic I'm going to discuss today with some interesting research which has been published recently. Hello, welcome to Pelvic News Channel. This is the channel for all pelvic physiotherapists or physiotherapists with an interest in the pelvic region. And in this channel, we will discuss the latest scientific research, news, and connect colleagues from all over the world. If you like this channel, please give it a thumbs up and hit the notification bell just below. An Entrocele is also called a small bowel prolapse. It can only be diagnosed with, for instance, MRI or defecography. And we pelvic physiotherapists cannot really diagnose this. But it's important to keep it into consideration, because if you're treating a patient, for instance, and the outcome is unsatisfactory and it's due to a small bowel prolapse or an Entrocele, well, that's explainable. Therefore, I think that the study I'm going to discuss today is very relevant for us. The aim of the study that I'm going to discuss today is to determine the clinical phenotypes of patients with an Entrocele, to see if there are any anatomical or functional associations, and to improve the assessment of pelvic floor disorders. And all patients with anal rectal complaints for at least 6 months were eligible for inclusion. So what are considered anal rectal complaints? I'm going to read them from paper because it's quite a list. So anal rectal complaints could be pelvic pain, bearing down, anal proccidentia, which is rectal prolapse, dyschezia, sensation of blockage at defecation, sensation of incomplete evacuation, straining during defecation. It could also be a mucus discharge, anal bleeding, and fecal incontinence. Patients who were pregnant had pelvic radiation, inflammatory bowel disease, anal or rectal cancer, or an anal or rectal stricture were excluded from the study. The patients had to fill in several questionnaires and were tested, and they had to fill in questionnaires on, for instance, incontinence, constipation, and quality of life. They also had an anal rectal manometry, a rectal distension test, and a defecography. Patients with an Entrocele diagnosed by defecography were matched with patients without an Entrocele, and they were case matched by age and sex. And one patient with an Entrocele was matched with two patients without an Entrocele. In total, 135 patients with an Entrocele were case matched with 270 patients without, so in total 405 patients were included. If we have a closer look at the patients with an Entrocele, the mean age was 57.6 years and nearly 93% were women. They had had significantly more pelvic surgery and hysterectomy. And the complaints that were significantly associated were a rectal prolapse, irritable bowel syndrome with the constipation type, and pelvic pain. There was no difference in the anal rectal manometry between the groups. So the patients with the Entrocele and the patients without an Entrocele had the same outcomes in anal rectal manometry. As can be expected, there were differences in the defecography. And the significant differences were that patients with an Entrocele had more an overt rectal prolapse, more resting perineal descent, and a perineal descent during defecation. And another outcome is that if we have a look at the emptying of the bowel, and then the emptying of 80% or more of the bowel, then the patients with an Entrocele, 46% were able to evacuate, and the patients without an Entrocele, this was 63%. And I like this research because it can help us in our clinical reasoning. if we have, for instance, a female patient with an anorectal complaint and the treatment is not progressing as expected, and she's had pelvic surgery in the past, we might consider an androcele, or if she's had an hysterectomy or a rectal prolapse, just to keep this androcele in the back of our mind. And in that case, we can maybe consult with a physician to see if she has an androcele and improve patient care. Well, I hope you liked this video. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up or subscribe to my channel. Or you can also read the blog at pelvicnewschannel.com. See you next time. Bye-bye.